In this video, I will give you every player that you need to succeed for the doubleheader today on FanDuel in 5 minutes or less. Happy Turkey Day, my name's Quick Pick Nick, and having simulated nearly 2 million different combinations of roster builds, here are your locks and lotteries for this Thanksgiving Day, Thursday, November 26th. If you like this kind of fast-paced calculated content, subscribe and stay tuned for more lineups throughout the season. I'll be taking the day off today as I will likely find myself somewhere amidst a food coma, so there won't be a video tomorrow, but we'll be right back on track with full lineups under 5 minutes on Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Starting off this lineup with our first lock at quarterback, my model recommends Deshaun Watson. Out of these four options, there are really only two that I would legitimately consider good enough to find a spot in our roster, Watson himself and Matthew Stafford. Andy Dalton had a good game last week, but faces a significantly more intimidating opponent in the Washington football team compared to the Vikings, and Alex Smith is yet to surpass 16 fantasy points in a game, even against softball opponents like Detroit and Cincinnati. While Watson is $1,500 more expensive than Stafford on FanDuel, the reason we are taking Watson over Stafford is because Watson is far more reliable and consistent. Aside from a low-scoring game in Cleveland a couple of weeks back, Watson hasn't fallen below 20 fantasy points since week 3, whereas the less consistent Lions quarterback couldn't even produce double digits as recent as last week against Carolina. The extra cash is well worth the near guarantee that we'll get at least 20 fantasy points, especially with his matchup against Detroit's 25th ranked defense in pass yards allowed per game. The next two locks will be both of our running backs, as my model selected Antonio Gibson and DeAndre Swift. Against Dallas, I think that almost any running back would be a lock, as Dallas ranks second to last in the league in rush yards allowed per game. With Gibson, we already have proof of his ability to run over the Cowboys' defense, as in Week 7, Gibson rushed for 128 yards against Dallas. The only player with an easier matchup than Gibson is Swift, as the only team in the league that ranks worse than Dallas in rushing yards allowed per game is Houston, allowing nearly 160 yards on the ground per game to opposing teams. Swift has shown reliability and consistency recently as well, averaging over 17 fantasy points per game over the past couple of weeks, including a 23-point performance against Washington's 10th ranked defense against running backs. With these two moderately priced players facing the two worst defenses in the league in stopping the run, I feel confident with both of these locks as our running backs. One more pick I would consider a lock is the Cowboys defense, as the amount of money we save by taking the downgrade here is well worth the potential loss in points. Think of it as almost trading points for money at the defense position, as although the Dallas defense might only score a few points while the top ranked Washington defense might score 10, we would save $1,500 on FanDuel. In this situation, it's a matter of taking either 5 or so extra points in Washington or $1,500 in Dallas, and that 5 or so points we're missing out on here will be more than made up for in the wide receiver and tight end positions. Speaking of which, our first lottery is our tight end, TJ Hockenson, as he's really the only tight end in the slate who sees wide receiver numbers on his team in terms of targets and fantasy performance. The reason Hockenson's a lottery is because there are other tight ends who have decent consistency on their teams, including Logan Thomas or Jordan Akins, but with Hockenson, you're getting a player who almost acts as another pass-catching threat for the Lions, recording the 5th most receptions per game as a tight end. Plus, with Kenny Galladay inactive, Hockenson will likely see a slight bump in usage. For the 4 remaining lotteries, my model chose Terry McLaurin, Will Fuller, Brandon Cooks, and Marvin Jones Jr. McLaurin is clearly Washington's top guy, and facing a Dallas defense that ranks last in the league in passing touchdowns allowed per game, I wouldn't be surprised to see a touchdown or maybe two out of the former Buckeye. Similarly, Fuller is Houston's clear wide receiver one, and against a Detroit team that has allowed the 8th most receiving yards per game to opposing teams, Fuller should also be able to find success today. Cooks should be primed for success as well, given that fantastic matchup, and he should find even more volume today since Randall Cobb has been ruled out. Tying it all together here, with Galladay out of action for the Lions, Jones will once again act as Detroit's top receiving threat alongside Hockenson, which he has done a good job of recently, averaging over 13 fantasy points per game through the past 5 weeks. That's what my model was able to come up with for the 2 games slate on FanDuel today, this Thanksgiving Day, November 26, 2020. With the top-ranked quarterback, the 2 best matchups for running backs, 3 wide receiver ones and a wide receiver 2 at flex, and the top-ranked tight end, I feel very confident about every player in this lineup. One aspect that may be missing for you is America's team, as aside from Dallas's defense, which wasn't even chosen for points, just mainly their big money-saving potential, we don't have a single Cowboy. Although I do think this is the best lineup here, if you believe we should have at least one player from every team, you could upgrade Jones to CeeDee Lamb using the remaining 200, but Lamb does face a rather difficult Washington secondary as Dallas's second receiver, as compared to Jones's easy Houston secondary as Detroit's first wide receiver, which is why I'm sticking to the former option. In closing here, I just wanted to thank all 200 some of you who have subscribed to my channel. And trust me when I say we're here for the long run, so thanks for sticking along so far and hope to see you down the stretch. This has been Quick Pick Nick, the intersection for sports, data analysis, and speed. Thanks for watching.